But you have to be 14 years old to enjoy that.
The atmosphere is anything but. The crowd have been chanting and singing, not just this afternoon, but throughout the entire weekend. There's a great love for Formula One here, and no small amount of expectation. Let's hope today's Grand Prix can meet it. At 2,285 metres above sea level, the thin air of the Autodromo Hermanos Rodriguez poses a unique challenge, not just to a driver's skill, but to the efficiency of their engines as well. 17 corners make up a lap of this 2.6-mile circuit, and you can expect incredible speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour, and overtaking too into the hard braking zones of turns 1.
Russell needs a better car, most definitely.
Joining me for the Grand Prix once again is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Jilks. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
It's been a really solid year so far. There have been some incredible standout performances, but what's really impressed me has been the consistency. With this kind of form, I'm expecting another great race today.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside.
Obviously.
The rest of today's grid, we have Verstappen, Vettel, Alexander Albon, and Gasly, Jilks, Magnussen, Perez.
Move up two positions because of stupid penalties.
Weber, Russell, Devon Butler, and Giovinazzi. Stroll, Kubica, Romain Grosjean, and Carlos Sainz. Raikkonen and Nico Hülkenberg.
Oh my god.
And now it's time to head down to the track.
Can this game just keep punishing me even more or not?
You should have some space going into the first corner, so try to keep it tidy.
Try to keep it tidy. Okay, 152. Only 3 seconds difference between 2 and 3 stop. Fastest time. One stop. Then 91.50 fuel, 71 laps, 72.1 fuel. Bear with me, guys. At the start of a race, we always go through this same procedure, don't we? At the start of a race, so it can get a bit hectic, and I really can't start as fast as the AI no matter what. It's just crazy. Do you know what? What I tried to do then was move my fuel mix up to rich. But then I couldn't see it. It took my fucking screen away of my revs per RPM. So it's either I could do that, or move it up as soon as we go. It's a bit better start. Not perfect, but. You cheeky fuck. Fuck off!
focus now for the rest of the race.
I didn't mean to do that. I've just broke late by accident.
Okay, entering lap 3 now. DRS has been enabled. One lap of extra fuel, fuel target plus one. We're leading our teammate by 5.9 seconds. Is 2.2 seconds.
Fucking hell, Weber.
Okay, we've lost a position. That's us down a place. expecting rain in around 10 to 15 minutes. Is 2.4 seconds. Okay, the boots aren't looking too warm at this point. We should have plenty of life left in them. Let's make sure we keep managing them properly. Gap to the car in front is 5.1 seconds. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the softs.
Put it with soft, medium, medium. I thought our strategy was soft, medium, medium. What's going on here? We're much faster than Hülkenberg. So fast. Toro Rosso's are so fast, man. So fast. Our job today is to hold off Magnussen. Which we're successfully doing. It was soft, soft, medium, was it? Okay, fair enough. My mistake.
Behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap.
Oh shit, I got that area of the track wrong. Totally wrong. I thought I was on the later part then, when I went round there. I thought I was on this part. So rain is coming in 10 minutes. These guys have got to be pitting in and around the same time as me. Surely. There's no way I can keep going for 10 minutes on these tyres. That's ludicrous. I'd be nice to wait until wet tyres. I can't.
Gap to car in front is 7.3 seconds.
These tyres are so bad. Am I pitting now? Oh, now we're boxing.
next box. Exit now. Okay, two stops left now. Two stops. Soft tyre, softs on the car behind. Is in for his stop. limited as the conditions change.
Hey Samu, thanks for the raid, much appreciated.
Some information on Albon. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car.
Uh-oh, it's rain time. As always, smooth on the wheel. Smooth is the way to go. Okay, has anybody pitted yet for Inters? No. Shit. Do we pit now or do we go out for another lap? That's the question. That is the question we need to ask ourselves. We got decent pace all of a sudden out of nowhere. I mean, Kevin Magnussen, since his pit, is 18.6, 19.4. And we're doing 18.9, 17.9. Decent pace, finally. Go one more, that's what I was thinking. Full homo. It's getting a bit slippery out here, I'm not gonna lie.
information on Weber. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow.
Fucking hell. How can they just still be this fast on a track that's getting wet? Don't get it. I just don't get it.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
That's me giving up. Fucking, what's this strategy he's giving me? I don't get it. He's asking me to pit lap 37 instead of lap 29. What about the wet tyres? Don't get this game, I really don't.
A new strategy is available on the MFD.
How's the AI this fast on a track this wet? Make any fucking sense. It's fucking soaking, look. I can't. How? How did he just get round that corner? Tell me. Please, someone.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
I'm sliding all over the place here.
Gap to the car ahead is 2.6 seconds.
Fucking ridiculous. I fucking hate the rain in this game, I really do. Look at them go, it's like... They're on fucking slicks! Look! I fucking... Sepp's getting absolutely fucking raped. Oh my god. Starting to really get fed up with this. Oh yeah! How the fuck did you brake later than me and manage to get... I'm sorry, it's not even funny no more. We're on slick tyres, the track is fucking damp. Yet, the Renault on the inside can brake later than me and just go round the corner like it's nothing. Yet I'm fucking sliding and braking in the... It's fucking ruined. The rain ruins this game. I can't get, like, it's not possible for me. It's just not possible. I'm sorry, game. I'm sorry. You got it totally fucking wrong.
We pretty much burned off our excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. We're leading our teammate by 22.5 seconds.
Okay. Look, I'm sliding. But it's fine for the AI. I'm not even barely pressing the accelerator. Look at the fucking grip he's got. No worries, see ya! You got some random impossible traction coming out of that corner. How? He's on slicks. Am I missing something here? Is it me? It must be me. There's no way it could be this bad. Look at him go. He's fucking gone. I'm sliding all over the place here. Is this even happening right now? Are we racing in the rain on slicks? And they're driving around like that? It's just, I'm barely fucking doing anything. It's just really, really losing my patience with this. And I've been driving sim racing games since I was a fucking baby. And this is just the worst wet weather experience. And I'm including Codemasters' own games into that. Never remember it being this bad with the AI. Still on fucking slicks here. Fuck's sake!
2.9 seconds. They're speeding up again, so I expect they fixed whatever the problem was.
Why are we still on these tires? I'm so close to retiring right now. So close.
We're getting very close to the crossover point now. Stay out if you have the pace, but as soon as you hit the limit, come and put the inters on. Gap to teammate behind is 20.8 seconds.
Ridiculous, they're catching up with me like I'm not even here.
Okay, gap ahead is 4.2 seconds.
Another race ruined by the fucking rain. Is there any possible way that I can do this any fucking faster? I don't care who you are.
A new strategy is available on the MFT.
This is just fucking... This is an actual joke now.
Understood. Copy that.
Actual joke. I'm this close.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Okay, copy that.
Oh, here we go. Everyone telling me how to drive.
Nico is in the pits. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those
Don't
tires.
Start. Really? Really?
Has been disabled by the stewards. DRS will be offline.
Fuck that corner, I don't give a shit.
Front is 7.8 seconds. to the car ahead is 8.4 seconds.
Twenty-eight three six. Finally, I'm actually matching somebody's time. Thank fucking God. No, unfortunately, you can't change the weather options in Korea. Ain't no way I'd do 40 laps in the wet. Welcome to Codemasters. Aggravating game. Okay, here comes my little whine, as usual, about this, about wet weather in this game. Right? So, what happens in real life when it rains at a racetrack when people are racing, right? People are, number one, all over the place to begin with. They have to adjust to the track because it's this wet, that wet. Is it this damp? Is it a bit damper? It's even more wet than the lap before, etc. It's ever changing when it's wet. You can't just go up, just brake perfectly at every corner and accelerate out of every corner perfectly. There's only one person that can do that, the AI in Codemasters. As a human, we have to adjust to the rain. We can't just drive around at the optimal time. The proof in that was the German Grand Prix a couple of weeks ago. Look at the drivers on the first few laps. They were all over the fucking shop. People going wide, people on the hairpin off in the fucking stadium, they were going that wide because they're brake, you know, they had to adjust. And even still, they went off into the fucking boards. Even when they adjusted to the track, they still get flying off the track. But the AI, they're just coded to just drive at the optimal pace, whatever the conditions. Which isn't fair on the human player. Because we can't do that. It's impossible. There's no driver in the world that can do that. I'm sorry. It's just the facts. There's no driver in the world that can do that. They have to adjust to the track as they go round. Anyway, that's my whine for now. Hopefully, as I have adjusted a little bit, as you can see from my last lap being a 28.33, and the car in front of me, not behind me, the car in front of me was also a 28.33. Oh, whoops. I did all that, and then I straight and went reading in chat again. Why do I do that? See, I've already lost my train of thought for this corner. Fuck you.
You coping okay in this weather? We're watching the amount of standing water on the road. For now, we think it's safe.
See, 28-0. Now I did a 28-0. Fuck.
A new strategy is available.
Let me guess. Fucking wet. Full wets.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Gap to car in front is 7.7 seconds. Confirmed.
What? Are you kidding me? Have people gone on full wets? Oh, I thought... He's got new winters already. What the fuck's... I'm so confused.
Start aquaplaning with those tyres. We think you're all right for now, but it might not be long before we switch to the full wets.
Yeah, you think?
Nico is in for his stop. Is 6.3 seconds.
People putting the full wets on. Lewis Hamilton's gone and put the full wets on. Shit, I don't know what to do. I thought I was second then. It's getting slower and slower, isn't it? Right up to 31 now. Weather report.
We should see a transition to light rain in around 10 minutes' time. Full wets seem to be the fastest tyre for now.
This is horrendous. This is actually horrendous right now.
couple of moments from other cars in the last lap or so, the intermediates are definitely starting to struggle. Might be time to move on to the full wets. Nico is in for his stop.
What? Weather report.
Weather should improve in 10 minutes' time. Light rain in 10 minutes.
I don't know.
Wets seem like the best tyre for now.
I don't know what to do, guys. I'm gonna take the gamble and stay out.
The gap to the car behind is 16.0 seconds. Okay, gap ahead is 9.9 seconds.
Everyone's pitting for wets. But the weather's gonna improve in a bit. Oh, let's stay out.
It might be worth thinking about putting a set of full wets on. We've seen a few people change over.
Oh, it's Verstappen. Ah! He's gone. He's gone.
Rain to ease up in around 5 minutes. 5 minutes till light rain.
Yeah, I'm staying on here.
3.5 seconds. Using 2 seconds a lap to the car behind. 2 seconds.
Come on, this gamble must pay off. Come on. Yeah, it's pretty bad. I'm not gonna lie.
the gap behind is 5.2 seconds. Our gap to the car in front is 4.2 seconds.
Come on, you said it was going to lighten up in 5 minutes' time, Jeff. Where is it? Where is the light rain, huh? Weather report.
Okay, the rain should ease up in a couple of minutes. Light rain soon. Full wets seem to be the fastest tyre for now.
Are you kidding me? Fucking give me a penalty for that shit.
The gap behind us is 11.3 seconds.
Oh my God. Where's this fucking light rain, huh? Getting absolutely raped here. Still in P7. Weather report.
This light rain is going to be with us for a while now. Full wets seem like the best tyre for now. The car behind's catching you at a rate of about 2 seconds a lap.
Ah, not much then.
safety gap to the car ahead is 5.3 seconds.
Well, that was 3 seconds faster than my last lap. You said the car behind was catching by 2 seconds. Technically, I should have been second faster, right? Jeff, right? That was a 1:31 again.
The gap to the car behind is 4.1 seconds.
That was a 1:30.
8.0 seconds.
Surely it's getting more for the inters now, right, Jeff?
Track is drying, but it's going to take a while to clear the standing water off the line. Don't start thinking about slicks just yet. Our gap behind is 3.5 seconds. Checo is in the pits.
One 28.7. Come on. Come on.
10 minutes left of this rain, then we think it's gonna dry up. 10 minutes. Seconds.
Excuse me. Shit.
Okay, you're in the top 10.
Bloody hell.
Okay, at the current pace and fuel settings, we won't have enough fuel for the end of the race. Consider lowering the fuel mix. front is 12.8 seconds.
But it just goes past like it's nothing. I tell you what, considering the situations we've been through, and I've managed to hold Weber behind me this whole time. Okay, Vettel was a bit different. He just said, see you later in his Ferrari. But I tell you what, guys, I'm pleasantly, it's going to be surprising to hear me use that word, I am pleasantly surprised at how all this has turned out. Vettel, I'm not worried. To keep Weber behind me for this long, he's probably going to have me now, but I've kept him at bay for long enough, because I'm guessing the last part of the race is going to be dry, so I mean, did I finally adjust to have a decent pace? Look, I automatically went all the way down here, but I'm all the way up here. We actually adjust to a decent pace? I mean, what are we doing? 127s? 128.3? 128.3? 128.0? So we're doing 127 to 127, for example. There you go, 128.4, 127.2. So, we actually found the pace. We found the pace in the end on the inters. Not only that, my inters are a lot more worn than theirs because they went on the wets. And they were literally two, 3 seconds a lap faster than me while I was on the wets. But my gamble technically paid off because we come out the other end of this, okay, with slightly more worn inters, but we're a bit higher up in the field, I believe, by the time all this drama has ended. Cheers, Mad Monk. Yeah, well, I'm really, you can probably tell by watching my webcam, my concentration levels just fucking skyrocket in situations like this. How far, oh, shit. Save it, just in case. Touch wood, you know, crashes and stuff. Not a car crash, I mean a game crash. What did you say there? Sorry. How far behind is Nico? Bloody gonna lap him. Nico's 13th. Look at these. They haven't even got enough room left to fit more tyres. That's how bad it is. Look, this. Look how much of a joke. Codemasters really need to do something. Either that. Just if I just took a screenshot of this, sent it to them and said sort it out. I mean, why did they pick? Salamander, why did they pit for inters after only doing like 4 laps on them? No wonder I'm going to lap Nico. Look at Nico, right? So soft, ignore the dries. He went on the inters, yeah. Then it started getting more wet and it said teammate is in the pits. I assumed he's going to put some wets on, right? I assumed that. But no, he put another set on inters on. I mean, what the fuck? He literally did like 3 laps on them. We can probably see here. So he... he did 6 laps in total on inters. And those, there's two separate sets of inters there. That's 2 separate sets of inters, 6 laps. He came in lap 31 and changed to the inters. Look at that. He came in lap 36 and changed to the inters. Came in lap 37 and changed to the wets. What the fuck? No, but everybody did it, Conquin. Everybody did it. Look. Look at them all. Everybody has done it. I'm the only one who's on my original inter tyre. And possibly Hamilton is the only one who didn't do it. But everybody else, look, here, all of these, every single one of them, Albon's out the race anyway, all of them have done it. All of them changed their inters within 1 lap of going to the wets. Look, 6 laps again. He came in lap 36 to change from inter to inter, right? Came in lap 37 to change from inter to wet. Do you see that? Unless everybody had a puncture. And rain at Mexico, will it? Yeah. There you go. And you saw the weather report, didn't you, Salamander? It wasn't this bad. It was one cloud with one drop of rain. That was it. This has been fucking like a monsoon. Oh, okay. I need to just a minute. Have a couple of bit of vapes on here, a couple of bit of nicotine, and resume. But yeah, overall, my race, it's going okay. In my opinion. In my opinion. It's going okay. God, if I have been concentrating in this wet weather. Rain at Abu Dhabi, yeah, wouldn't surprise me. Wouldn't fucking surprise me. Do you know how I've had rain in every single race but one this season, but one. Right. Weber's probably going to have us now, but it was coming. That was coming sooner or later, wasn't it? I'll push him to over here. Not literally, but just so he's got a harder turn in. But he don't care, look. Now we've got Grosjean going to take us as well.
Virtual safety car, virtual safety car. Reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta.
What are you doing, Weber? Oh, he's the one that's out. That didn't even make any sense. And now I've gone over here. Looks like I can't do that again. That's fucking ridiculous.
Is 2.0 seconds. Nico is in for his stop.
Thank fuck for that. Oh,
complete, go now.
What a bitch.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Look at Butler coming at me. What the fuck?
and go, but could be worth the risk. Be ready if you want to box. Car ahead is coming to fit the mediums. Car ahead, now running medium tyres.
Where's my dear S, eh?
Gap to the car ahead is 2.0 seconds. Is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Catching the car ahead, but be aware that these tyres need to last till the end of the race. Green flag. Where? There's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags.
Really, Hülkenberg? Really?
Is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. Started to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. We won't be making another pit stop. second a lap to the car behind, 1 second. Gap to car in front is 4.5 seconds. Hamilton's out in front. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Flag. Okay, gap ahead is 5.1 seconds. At the moment, the car behind us is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. Fuel remaining. there's only one lap of fuel remaining. Good job, you did really well. Super driving.
It's certainly been an incredible year for Formula One, and our drivers have all pushed themselves this season, making it one of the most compelling years of racing in history. There can only be one.
Well, guys, P4, would you actually believe it?
World Drivers Champion.
P4.
And Mercedes have pulled off a great.
It was, wasn't it? I said, I'm going to stay out. Yes, I was 3 seconds slower at one point to the wet tyres, but it worked.
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today, speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars...
I felt like I've worked really hard for that. Lewis wins again, obviously. I mean, the championship. Oh, God.
And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. We also crown a new champion today, as their lead at the top is now an insurmountable one. What a great year it's been for Formula One.
Devin Butler gets second somehow.
But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Well, after a drive like
how did the Ferrari end up behind us? That's strange.
See how hungry he was for every position he took today.
Let's move on to the constructors. It's another clear win for Mercedes as they managed
both Toro Rosso's out.
Incredible performance for the whole team. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team.
I tell you what, those Haas were putting up a good fight. I'm not going to lie, they put up a real good fight, or Magnussen did anyway. But he lost out to Perez and Vettel in the end. Where were they? Because Magnussen was right behind me. Oh, we've actually got highlights for this race. Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Matuidi. Oh, let's just sit back and relax for a minute and watch the highlights. Oh, I tell you what, 100% distance when it's conditions like that is very taxing. Mentally and physically. God knows in a real fucking F1 car what they get put through when it gets like that. Oh, fantastic result though. P4. Fucking pleased with that. Sorry. I didn't mean to take that spot. Oh, whose wing is that over there? Super wide. That's when it was pissing it down. Look at me squirming everywhere, but managing to keep it in check. Hey, and considering the conditions were like this as well, I can't even remember using many flashbacks. I remember using one because I looked at chat. But you know, I would have expected a lot more. Fucking solid result. Absolutely solid. Is that when they came out on the wets? Slow-mo shot in the rain. Coming around the left-hander. Checkered flag, P4. More lock-ups. To be honest, I don't actually lock up that much, considering I have all the assists off. Just pretty good on the brakes. I Let's see where we are. Where did Bottas finish? Third. Okay, so he would have caught up. So we're 4 points ahead of Bottas. That's, we're not going to... I think we could probably get around fifth in the driver standings, which is good. Constructors. We still managed to keep ourselves solidly ahead of Racing Point, which is our target right now. 63 points ahead. It's perfect. Very good, very good, very good.
Great work out there today. Let's have your thoughts.
Hi Claire, how are you doing?
Your teammate had a rough time out there and wasn't able to finish. That's got to be frustrating for him.
He has a good car and a good team behind him. I'm sure the problem will get fixed. I'll be nice about it.
Devin did much better in today's race than he did in qualifying. Were you expecting that?
You can never count him out. You can never count him out as best in the car. I'm going to say it's in the car he's driving. Because I don't want to give him too much credit.
Really,
I want to give the car credit.
The field today. What was your strategy?
Just not pit in. I used the car's nimbleness, the aero package, the car's nimble, like... a foot to the floor then, I suppose.
It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it?
Everyone is a team sport. Maybe they should expect more.
Appreciate your time.
Cheers, Claire. See you later. It keeps pissing you off. Imagine all assists off in those conditions then. You'll get pissed off for sure.